The tractor started off over about 20, 25 or so years ago, really, and it started off just as a single two-wheel drive tractor. And then as we did more farming, because of the money side of it, I just kept adding to it. It revolved over quite a few years. Really, the development in it revolved over about 8 years until it got to this configuration. I did a lot of welding. I did a lot of sourcing parts because the whole tractor was only built for about $12,000 in actual cost, and it's been used far more than I ever thought it would. The engines in it are 2671 Detroits. The Detroit are a two-stroke diesel with blowers on the side of them. The first of these engines in the Detroits was developed in 1935. Of course, I've updated them over the years, but originally they were called Grey Marine, and they had 2671s in the General Grant tanks in World War II. The front transmission that was revolved around Chamberlain always had a weakness for Chamberlain tractors, so in the old ones. But the front one is not strictly all Chamberlain. It has a scraper back end in it. The back section of it is all Chamberlain. It's a Detroit engine, but Chamberlain's come out with 371 Detroits. I just doubled the size up and put 671s in. This is probably its 19th year. It's been running like this, very little trouble with it. And because of the Narracourt tractor rally this year, it actually got it had a good service and actually got a paint job. Like an articulated tractor, has one engine with a power transfer box that drives into the two diffs. Now this tractor has the two transmissions, like the front engine to the back engine, run completely separate to each other. There is no power transfer between the two. It is purely as two units hooked together to make one, and it just pivots in the centre to do the steering. The whole tractor, I haven't really weighed it officially, but we've weighed components of it. It weighs about 18 tonne. Now, it's around about the 11 tonne on the front axle. Now, you'd think that's too much, but as the load when the load pulls, it actually transfers the weight onto the back, and we consider we got it about 50-50. The gears are pre-selected. We only basically work in one gear all day, so the gears are pre-selected, but the clutch on the front part of it is electric, and the back one, of course, is manual. Now, you just bring the clutch up on the front one until it just starts to pull, and do the same on the back, and then just move off, just give it a bit more and move it off. Basically, the throttles, you just bring them up to about 1200 revs, and that's enough to pull your loads off. It's a Shearer wide seater. It was actually developed down at Kilkenny in Adelaide, and they had a research and development farm up at Wombe. Now, they used it for a number of years up at Wombe, and when the farm closed down, I purchased it from them up there. The seater is 105 sowing rows. It sows on 7-inch spacing, and it is 62 feet wide. It sows at. It holds about 6 tonne of seed and super. Depending on our speed, at today I'd be doing about 50, 55 acres an hour. We cut our speed back because we're making the ground too fine. We're basically sowing in the old term 7 mile an hour. All this up the top here that you see, that's the gauges and the just for the front engine, and the ones that you see down here, they're for the back engine. The clutch for the front engine works on electric on these two buttons on top of the clutch. Manual clutch for the back part of it. These here are the gears for the back, hydraulic levers. Then we go up here onto the side here. This operates the throttle, just the stopper. And that's just a in and out for our spray unit.